Alright, in this one I wanted to quickly show a tool that I just discovered to do language translation from the terminal. So yeah, I was looking for an apartment, but yeah, every description is in German, so it's a nightmare. I have to copy paste into Google Translate and it's slow and it's annoying. So I was looking for this kind of tool, and it turns out that there is one called Translate shell, which is a very minimalistic thing, which I think by default it uses Google Translate. So it will just query Google Translate with whatever you give it, and yeah, you can just do pacman s translate shell if you're on Arch Linux, and it will just install it. And the way it works is you just say, well, trans. And then you just pick a string that you want to translate. So, bonjour, tout le monde. And it will translate it, hello everyone. And it will say some other details. And so yeah, it can translate in, it can auto-detect the language. Think if I remember my Netherlands, yes, it's another thing. You can specify, you can force the language codes like so. So if I want to translate from Dutch to English, but I can translate from Dutch to French, and it will translate this to French. It can of course take stuff from the standard input instead of just passing it as an argument. I think, so yeah, as you can see, by default, it's a bit verbose. So it says like the translation and it says like the definition of words and so on. So what you can do is give it the flag brief, which will, well, make it brief. I think there is, you can give, say, a view, which will put it in a pager. Like so, you can, instead of this, you could pass it as a file. So, could say, think inputs t, like so. Yeah, same behavior. And the interesting part, maybe, is that there is, as I said, different engines, and by default, auto, I would guess, is Google. But you can see there is Bing, Yandex, which are the proprietary one. But there is one called Apertium that is apparently open source. And I couldn't make it work. So it works. It's very slow, of course, because open source. Huh? But if I try to use it with trans-e for to pick the engine, Apertium, and I say bonjour. It says, yeah, it cannot get it, unfortunately. So that one doesn't work for me. Otherwise, in addition to translation, it can also do a dictionary lookup with Aspel. Aspel is like the GNU spell checker. I think spell is just the maybe Unix generic one. But anyway, if you do like Aspel and then something like this, it will give you all the possible combinations. I didn't look too much into it if you can actually do translation with this, but I don't know, I would doubt it. Maybe there is a way. And so, but so like the advantage, if there is a way, please tell me, would be that this is actually just on your local system. It doesn't query anything at all on the internet. You just have to install some dictionaries, so you have all the dictionaries in different languages and you can install those. So yeah, and from this I made a small script that allows me to translate stuff with a prompt, basically. So I have a little prompt, and if I say bonjour tout le monde, it will pop up a window where it will show me the translated text. Yep, that's me. I have a thing where I can edit in an editor. so on, and it will give me in another window the translation. Or I can just use it from the clipboard, you know, if I say, I translate, copy paste this, and I say from the clipboard, it will, well, I'm translating English to English, but you see my point. It's a convenient script that I will use in my apartment search so that I can just copy paste the stuff and press a few shortcuts to translate it. There is one last thing that I found. I don't know, it seems a bit useless, but you can actually play the audio. So there is some text-to-speech thing, so trans-p, like so. And so, well, maybe I want to hear it. But if I say, bonjour tout le monde.
Translations of
bonjour tout le monde.
Hello, everyone.
So, yeah, that was, I don't know, kind of funny, a bit quirky, maybe. Although I guess if you're making like some kind of app to talk to other people via audio, that could be quite a nifty tool. But yeah, anyway, that's about it. I hope you liked this video and you discovered a convenient minimal tool. And yeah, see you in the next one.